is with a heavy heart and a deep sense of concern about the ongoing violence, chaos, and unrest in many parts of Nigeria that I make this appeal to the government and people of our dear country, Nigeria, to eschew violence and embrace peace and dialogue in finding solutions to the challenges we face as a country. I particularly appeal to President Muhammadu Buhari in his capacities as President of Nigeria, Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces, and as a parent of youth like the ones who have in the last week or so come out in peaceful protest against police brutality and for improvement in their lives and their living conditions, to restrain the military and other security agencies from using brute force as a way of ending the crisis. The shooting and murder of unarmed protesters, no matter the level of provocation, has never been effective in suppressing public anger and frustration. Instead, such actions only reinforce the anger and frustration of the populace and close the window of dialogue and peaceful resolution. It is clear that Mr. President and his lieutenants did not exhaust the opportunities for dialogue with the protesters before resorting to use of force. It is worse that there is denial of wrongdoing in spite of overwhelming visual evidence. Great harm has now been done, but it can be stopped before it completely spirals out of control. We are at a critical moment in this crisis, and Mr. President must act now before it is too late. This time demands leadership and mature leadership as such. Most of the demands of the protesting youth, which Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu of Lagos State swiftly took to the president, are not unreasonable and can be met without anyone's political interest or ambition being threatened. It is imperative that leaders at all levels, starting with Mr. President, must demonstrate meekness, humanity, humaneness, and sincerity in meeting the legitimate demands of the protesters and ensuring that justice is served where it must be served. These are the most potent ways of ending this crisis now. The youth too, I will want you to give peace a chance while making your legitimate demands. You must be mindful of miscreants who will infiltrate your ranks and give the protests a bad name only so that trigger-happy forces will kill you. The destruction and looting of public and private properties will only hurt all of us and set us back. The targeting of individuals and groups for attacks and reprisal attacks will only further widen our divisions, escalate the crisis, and threaten our fragile unity. This is yet another moment when our nation is on the edge of a cliff. Our individual and collective actions now and in the next few days will determine where we will go as a nation. May God help us in taking the right steps in the right directions.